today on behalf of Berlin Global, and we have the honor to have an interview with Her Excellency Ambassador Sitona Abdalla Osman. She is the ambassador of South Sudan in Germany. So, Your Excellency, in which position during your career from the South Sudanese liberation movement to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs do you think you gained the most experience? And which one did you find the most challenging?
Before I start, let me say thank you very much for coming here on behalf of the Global International. And I am really glad to be with you in this interview. And I am, yes, as your question, I was in the liberation movement since 1985. So until the time when we have a comprehensive peace agreement in 2005. And I have joined the Minister of Foreign Affairs at the quota from after the comprehensive peace agreement for the thousand, because in the comprehensive peace agreement there is a quota for the thousand on all the civil society organization or in the government of Sudan. So we have joined the Ministry of Foreign Affairs at that quota, 28%. So that is in 2007. So since that 2007, I worked in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs as in the Department of Planning. And after that, for 1 year, I moved in 2008. I would have been deployed in 2008 to the minister to Vienna. So I worked in Vienna for 3 years and a half, or 3 years and 8 months almost. After that, we have the Comprehensive Peace Agreement. According to the Comprehensive Peace Agreement, we have gained our independence through the referendum, because we have won the referendum by 98% for separation. So we became an independent country in 9 July 2011. And that what now made us to have a new ministries. One of the new ministries is the Minister of Foreign Affairs. And the Minister of Foreign Affairs is amalgamation between three departments at that time, or ministries at that time during the government of South Sudan, South Sudan government. That is the staff who came from Minister of Foreign Affairs, and the staff came from the international trade, and the staff came from the regional cooperation. All they have became a staff of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. So, and after that we have sworn in as an ambassadors, new ambassador for the Republic of South Sudan. And from there that I have been deployed to Germany in 2012. And this, I arrived here in July, end of July 2012, and I have presented my credential on the 24th of August. And about my experience, I have a long experience in the movement, as I told you, since 1985-2005. So I have a long experience there, and especially in the movement. But my experience also in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, it is not different much than my experience in the movement, because in the movement also we worked as also an ambassador for our movement. So we go outside, we talk about the movement, and we talk about the peace, we talk about many issues and women rights and many issues that also in that position we have been an ambassador to our movement.
Oh, that was my next question, actually. Since your academic career began in physiotherapy, how did you decide to become a diplomat?
Yes, that is also have a long history, but I will make it for you short, that I have been a student in Cairo University. And also when we went to the university, we have gone through a quota of a scholarship that from Egypt to the Republic of South Sudan, to the South Sudan at that time, mm-hmm. to the thousand who are coming from South Sudan. And that quota, it is the biggest quota in the from the student who coming from South Sudan to go to Egypt, around 200. So I was been one of them. And when we are there, we have formed also an association. That association, we call it SOSA. And this association also we work with for the student right. And I have been a member of the association as one of the leader in the association. And from there also, when we came back, I worked in Soba University Hospital as a physiotherapist. And still we have continued our relation as a student, and we still we work for the right of the people of the South. And during that time, so we have this problem of Sharia law, and that's 1983. And this problem of Sharia law with our orientation, political orientation, when we are a student also, that made us to think about what is going on in the South Sudan, what is issues, what is burning issues, what is happening in our country. And at that time, as I told you, that is the Sharia law, where the right of the people from South Sudan has been discriminated, as the South Sudan has, majority of them, they are Christian. And also in development, we didn't have that lack of from all the government who came to Sudan to develop the South Sudan, although all the resources coming from South Sudan. So we have issues like identity issues, like resources and development, like also religious in the same time. So we have issues actually as intellectual, we thought about it. And from there, we have a movement, a new movement, although we have before that, Anyanya one, that is in 1955, it started 1955 until 1972, where they have called for autonomous government. Our own fathers and grandfathers that called for autonomous government, and they have not got it. So because that they entered into civil war in 1955, that ended 1972 with this Ababa agreement. So in 1983 also developed another movement, this is, they call it Anyanya 2. So, and this is before 1983. Anyanya 2 started from 1982. And in 1983, when the Sharia law, now it started now another movement, this is the South Sudan People Liberation Movement, South Sudan People Liberation Army, this is in May 1983. So with all what happening there in Khartoum and all the discrimination we saw our people really, they are targeted. So because of that, that is what made me to decide to go and join the movement in 1985. So I left Khartoum in 1984, end of 1984. And by May 1985, I have joined the movement in Addis Ababa.
How important is the role of being the first official head of mission for the South Sudan, for the independent republic of South Sudan in Germany? And what are your main goals whilst holding this position?
To be the first that as ambassador from the Republic of South Sudan to a big country like the Federal Republic of Germany, it is a big task. And it is challenging task too, because you have to start from scratch. We have built all these things from nowhere. So we have to have the office, we have to have the resident. And in the same time, we have to have our name out. And that is the most important thing. Because our country at that time, yes, they got independence, they know it, but they don't know it in the political field or in diplomacy field. So, and we have to work according to the Vienna Convention. So to make all that, it means we have to foster the cooperation between the German and South Sudan, and we have to make ourselves known. We have to network with other organizations, with other embassies. We have to make ourselves, to give information to communication with media, so they can know exactly what is happening in South Sudan. So it means with all that in our mind, and in the same time with the task that it has been given to us by the president, when we are coming to deploy, when we are deployed to our stations, that we have to work for the investment of the country. We have to let our country names very known and clean, and we have to put our footsteps to telling them about the Republic of South Sudan. And that what also made us also to think about our plan for the first year and the second year too, because the first year we have to make ourselves like known, we are here, we are present, and with that one it has a lot of effort to do that, because we have to attend all the activity, we have to have our own activity, we have to invite many people so they can know about us and know we are exist. So this is also a challenging situation, and more challenging when you are a female ambassador, I think so. But yeah, we have done it.
How would you evaluate the relations between South Sudan and Germany, and how do you believe these relations have evolved since the independence of South Sudan in 2011?
Actually, the relation between the Federal Republic of Germany with the Republic of South Sudan, it was been a good relation, because we have a relation even before our independence with the German, and especially in the medical field and other fields, and even in the field of the peace and all this. But the most important thing that in the first day of the, we have been recognized, first day of our independence, we have been recognized by the government of Germany. So that is in the 9th of in the 9th of July 2011, immediately we have been recognized by the German government, and they have also they have an office before, but that office now it has been already became an embassy. So with an ambassador, so it means we are got that, you know, privilege to get most of your countries in the world to recognize the Republic of South Sudan very fast. Like we became in the UN country number 183, and in the EU, actually African Union also became the country 94. And that one, it is also help us that the German to have many projects, and especially, as I said before, they have a project in the field of the health and in the peace process. And even now they have a project in governance, they have a project in agriculture, they have a project in water, and also in capacity building. So this, it means it has been fostered during the time where we have been, become independent. So, and we have many people who have, from Germany, from the Bundestag, from the government, from the Minister of Foreign Affairs, from the Minister of BMZ, they have visited the Republic of South Sudan, as we have also exchanged a visit from many other ministers who have been in South Sudan, from South Sudan, who have visited Germany. So we have a very good cooperation, we have a good relation, and understanding relation, that we are partners and we are working as partners, because we are part of the development aid, so we have that privilege of getting also the development aid as a partner. Yeah.
What do you consider to be the most important issues of cooperation between South Sudan and Germany? And in which areas do you think there is space for improvement?
The most important area, actually, it is agriculture and water. This is the most important area they are working in. But there is a room of improvement in the field of health and improvement in the field of governance. And even in peace, you know, because we, since our independence, also the, our movement, it was not very easy, it was not very rosy, but it has its own sore. And because of that, we feel like we are like German, we back through the same what German has passed through before, like separation of the two German and how they unified themselves and how they really started the federal system. So, and we are also chosen that we have to have a federal system, but it is also different. So in such field, I think we can work together and we can improve our situation in the Republic of South Sudan.
Do you think that cultural diplomacy could eliminate the differences between states and prevent conflicts? And could this goal be achieved in the case of South Sudan?
Yes, because cultural diplomacy, it is very important for between region and region, between tribe and tribe, between community and community, because the language of cultural diplomacy, it is understandable with all the culture we have, and we are cultural people by nature. We are cultural people, we love our community, we love our culture, and because of that, this is one of the things that bring community together. When they really sit and understand each other, because we have some areas where in the borders, for instance, we have community where you can get community from South Sudan, the same tribe from South Sudan, and the same tribe it is in Uganda. You can get same tribe in South Sudan and the same tribe in Kenya. You can get same tribe in South Sudan and you can get it in Congo. So we are actually link with all our neighboring countries, so, and also link in the, our communities. We have more than 62 tribes, each tribe neighbor to other tribe, and each one has culture that they can be similar to each other, but they can also taking a little bit from each other. So with that understanding of cultural diplomacy, I think it can play a big role, especially in the peace process.
About the South Sudanese culture, how is the embassy trying to promote this culture in Germany?
Yeah, we promote this culture by showing our culture everywhere, and especially we have some forums, like for instance, the BMZ, they have a forum where country partners, they can present their culture in when they have an open day for public. And that one we have always, you know, since 2012 we participate. So we always show them the public, the German public, our culture. And at the same time, sometimes we have holding some cultural activity in our embassy. And at the same time, we call our community also for a meeting where we can also present our culture. And in other forums also, we have like ITB. We also participate in the ITB. In the same other times also, there is a parliamentarian who have activity in their own hometown. They invite us also, we go and show them our cultural activity. So, and you can see even our office, you can look at all things in the office represent our culture, because as I told you, we are a diverse community. We have 62 tribes, so we have to show all the other tribes to the German people public. And we have open day also in our embassy, where we open our embassy also to public to come and see our culture. And we have, sometimes we bring singers so they can sing and can dance. One time for the ITB, we brought our lady who are beauty lady, and also we have this cat fashion show. So this is the way we want to promote our culture in the German.
During the last years, tourism is a profitable activity in South Sudan. Do you believe that it can be a good means of spreading your culture abroad?
The ITB?
Tourism.
Yeah, the ITB, it is the tourist conference, yeah? You mean the one in March here in Germany? Yes, this is a good forum actually, because it's an international forum. It is well attended by more than 17,000, you know, participants. And for us, it is not profitable, because for us, it is, we present as an embassy. There is some other countries.
No, I didn't mean it was for you profitable. I mean for South Sudan.
Yeah, yeah, it profits South Sudan, of course, because from there, you know, when we present our culture, we present what we really area of tourism where they have never seen it before, and maybe many people they know don't know about it. Now, you know, we have many tourists who go to South Sudan because of our activity. Because we always show them how, what is there, what is really different than when you can get it in Kenya, or you can get it in Tanzania, or you can get it in Uganda, or you can get it in Ethiopia, and what is better and best if you can tour from the beginning, because the migration of the animal starts in the Republic of South Sudan. We have a very rare species. So we have many things, you know, people, they don't know about it. Like our forest, we have a very rich forest, need, for instance, research, need education, it needs many things to be done. You know, we have many other things like water resources, like our Nile. We have a beauty of landscape, you know, we have many things that people, they don't know about it. Because most of the things coming to the media, it is about war, about conflict, about what we are really seeing, you know, in the media, but we are have to portray ourselves different than what they see in the media.
And finally, Your Excellency, what advice would you give to young people who are interested in a career in international relations or diplomacy, but whose academic career hasn't begun from international relations?
Thank you very much. This is really a good question, and I really love it, because I always, as a women rights activist, also prefer that the youth, they have to get their space, the youth, they have to get their chance, and the youth always, we tell them always that you are the future of the country, but we don't give them what they deserve to be the future for the country. So I believe that in public diplomacy, that we, and cultural diplomacy, we have to be open. An open mind cannot come when you are just close to your books and close to your university and close to your own country. But you have to be exposed to outside, so you can know what is outside. Because with you knowing and you seeing, it is not like what you hear from radios or hear from anywhere, or you just read it in the book. But when you go there, you will learn the things you will never learn in the books. You will get more new things. And at the same time, I really believe that the youth, they have to take the challenge, because the challenge is start by you. Start by yourself. When you really want to make a difference in your life, not to look into, you know, the recreation life within you. You feel like, okay, this is what I do because my friend is doing this and my friend is doing that. No, you are not planning for yourself. And that's what I tell my son always. My son, plan for yourself. Don't let anybody to plan for you. Be leader of yourself. Don't let anybody to lead you. And that is what I want to leave it for the youth, that lead, please. And don't leave other people to lead you. And don't let people to tell you that you will be the leader of the future. You have to be the leader of today. Why you have to be leader of future? You have your space. You have to lead that space. And you have to think about how to lead for the future. For the future is yours, yes, but today also is yours. So work for today as you will work also for tomorrow. Yeah.
Okay. So is there anything you'd like to comment or add?
I want to commend your effort as also you are young and youth, and you also you are looking into different diversity. You know, the diversity is very important. You could have any interview with any other, but to choose a new country, to choose to come to interview an ambassador of the new country, that's also an appreciation. And that means that you are widening your scope, you are widening your mind. All the countries are the same, because some people, they think that, no, there is a big country, there is a big name, but no. We are here in Germany to be a representative, our government, our president, and all of us, we are equal. All of us, we can give a message that people really want to hear. Thank you.
Thank you very much for having us.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah.